So big O notation is very useful because we can use it to concentrate just on the fastest growing part of a function and even leave out all of the involved constants. So I now want to show you a few examples to make this more concrete. So 3n plus 1, for example, would be contained in O of n because we don't care about the plus 1, and 3n grows at the same rate, so it does grow at least as fast as n. The function 18n squared minus 50 would be contained in O of n squared because, again, n squared here is the fastest growing term. We do not care about the minus 50 and we don't care about constants. Now, very similar here, if you have 2 to the power of n plus 30, n to the power of 6 plus 123, that would be in O of 2 to the power of n. We do not care about the constant, and those two terms here, they both depend on n, but 2 of n outgrows the 30 n to the power of 6, and since we add those two terms here, 2 to the power of n is really just the fastest growing part. Now, if we don't add those two parts here, but for example, we multiply 2 to the power of n times n squared, we need to include that into the O notation, because just having 2 to the power of n, that grows slower than 2 to the power of n times n squared. So if we just had 2 to the power of n here, that statement would not be true, because 2 to the power of n grows slower than 2 to the power of n times n squared. So what about a statement like 3n plus 1 is contained in O of n squared? Because n squared clearly grows at least as fast as n, so this one must also be true. And it is true. The only thing is that it would be unusual to write this, because usually we're trying to state this bound here as tight as possible. Similar down here, you could also say that 18n squared minus 50 is contained in O of n to the power of 3. But again, this would be unusual to write, because if we have a tighter bound that we can state, we would state this part over here. So enough with the examples. I'm going to let you figure out the rest as our next quiz.